Cowherd, should Kyrie already regret leaving LeBron and the Cavs?
Well, I would have left at the minute I got on my private jet to Boston. You don't leave great because there's so little of it, and great rewards you in so many more ways than you give it credit for. One of the things that I noticed with Kyrie last night, when you play with LeBron, the shots are just a little easier, right? You just get a little better look. You can look at Kyrie Irving's career with LeBron and without. And the one thing that jumps out to me is field goal percentage. Over the course of 47% and 43, that's a different player. That's not 46 to 45. If you look at field goal percentage in the paint, that's like 52 to 48. Kyrie will score his points. Kyrie will be a great finisher. Kyrie will be a smart player. You're not going to get the looks. And over 82 games, it gets frustrating having to work harder for points.
Look, I think that's easy to say with Gordon Hayward and his fractured ankle. He was going to, if Hayward was there and he accepted the coaching from Brad Stevens, he was going to get looks because of the system.
Right.
And they were actually going to run a system rather than whatever LeBron wanted to do in that moment. And so, yeah, should he regret it? Yeah, well, as soon as Hayward went down, it's like, damn. Because his next 2 years are jacked, because he won't be back this year, and you can't tell me Hayward's going to come back the next year the same
guy. At 22-6.
The same guy. And so, yeah, this looks like this is a worst-case nightmare scenario.
Should he regret it? I mean, we can all say he should have never asked for the trade, but does he? I don't think so, because he had to count the cost. He didn't know where he would end up. He didn't know he was going to go to a Boston and Eastern Conference contender. For all he knew, he could have been in Phoenix. He could have been with some terrible team, and in his process of thinking, do I really want this trade, he had to consider that. Am I willing to go somewhere where we may not win just to be the man and be a point guard, a full-time point guard? I believe he had to take that into consideration. So as of yet, no regrets. When he will start regretting it is, let's say they're a lower-rung playoff team this year. Then what are people going to say? You ain't even as good as Isaiah Thomas.
Oh.
Isaiah Thomas at least got him 53 wins and got him to the Eastern Conference Finals. Because it's similar. Isaiah Thomas didn't have Gordon Hayward either. He had Avery Bradley and some defenders, but you got a Jaylen Brown who's got more talent than a lot of those guys that left, and a Jason Tatum who also has more talent. And over the next few years, if Kyrie can't lift this team to wins, big-time wins, deep playoff runs, and you look like just a street baller. You out there shaking people up, you know, shooting 43%.
By the way,
averaging a lot of points. Then your legacy begins to take a hit, and that's what you
regret. Chris, we're looking at this relationship of Kyrie and LeBron, I think, the wrong way. Here's how we should look at it. They didn't join forces and say, let's be a super team. Kyrie was drafted as the alpha, the number one pick overall. It's your team, it's your show. Then LeBron was thrust on him. He didn't ask for LeBron. Now, would he have taken him? Of course. But Kyrie went from being the number one alpha point guard running the show to, hey, it's LeBron's show. Now you play off him. As we've seen, Kobe and Shaq. We saw that, right, guys?
But
we saw
Kyrie that. Kobe?
Well, no. We're going to find out. And you know what Kobe was without Shaq? He was a 35-point-a-game guy out in the first round of the playoffs.
He also won maybe a couple championships.
He did when he got Pau Gasol. But maybe Kyrie will get Gordon Hayward back in a year, as you said. Or Jason Tatum will grow up. Or Jaylen Brown will. I think it's too early to say he regrets this.
Guys,
I mean, he's going to be okay.
How do all those receivers like Deion Branch do when they left Brady?
Yeah.
Don't leave great. In our life,
although, wouldn't you say Kyrie is on a higher level than those receivers at Brady?
No question.
Yes. Yeah. But Randy Moss, listen, I can go boom, 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 boom. Randy Moss, the best receiver I've ever seen after Jerry Rice. He was great with Tom, and then it implodes.
Like, there's great.
I will say this to your point. We killed Kevin Durant for giving up being the man so you could go win. Then we kill Kyrie Irving for leaving winning so you could be the man. Like, it's hard to have it both ways.
You can't win. Players can't win.
How about a new rule? If you play with LeBron, never leave.